What I'm about to say to you is very troubling. I need you to understand that. I'm about to talk about this man. And apologies to this man, but it's sexualization time. He's not real. He's a video game character, which makes it worse. Now, I need you guys to ask me, Brittany, have you ever played Call of Duty Modern Warfare in your life? Go ahead and ask me. No, I have not. I have never played Call of Duty. I don't know the plot. I know that it's Call of Duty. I'm assuming that's the military. Modern Warfare, I'm sure it's a bunch of like cool nighttime binoculars and scopes, whatever. Extended mag. Don't know what that means. Extended mag. Oh, it's a magazine. Okay, so I'm going to be put on a list for fucking Googling gun stuff. Whatever. Idiot. Why did I do that? Anyway, this man, I keep... Part of this is like the chicken and the egg, right? Am I the problem because I have spoken out loud with my mouth about having a mask kink? Is this my fault? Or is it the internet showing me what I need to see? What am I liking online to where the TikTok algorithm is like, oh, she's gonna love this one. And it puts an edit of Ghost from Call of Duty on my For You page. And I'm like, yeah. I'm literally like eating it up like it's fucking soup, slurping it and squelching it down my throat. Sometimes I feel like when I get to a certain level in these podcast episodes where it's like, we know this is about to be horny hour, right? I'm sitting in this chair. I come before you horny. I think it would be so funny if just a red sniper bullet or a red sniper dot just came like right here and just like leveled on me. And it was kind of like, you need to relax. Like, let's move on. But again, like I said, it's just me in this room, babe. It's just me, myself, and I. Me, myself, and I. It's all I got in the end. Me, myself, and my man. Thank you to my man. Thank you to my man. It's something about his eyes. Maybe I'm just very mentally ill. Maybe I just need to be shot. Maybe I just need to... Oh, God. Oh, I gotta show you guys some of these edits. Like, what are we talking about? I think it's... All right, Laura, can we add in some like paparazzi sounds and some camera flashes? All right, I will be taking one question at this time. Please limit it to one question. I am not taking many questions at this time. Yes, you in the red. Why am I attracted to Ghost from Call of Duty? That question isn't allowed. Thank you guys so much for your time today. All right, get home safe. And then I leave the press conference because that's fucking invasive, okay? I think that, namely, I am very ill. Arguably, incredibly unwell. And I think that does have something to do with it. Two, chronically online has a lot to do with it. Three, the content is out there, right? I'm just consuming what was made for me. I'm enjoying what's out there to be enjoyed. I love a male physique. I am a slut for a male physique. I am a slut for a man in a uniform. When he's got the fucking, he's got the vest on. And he's, you know how men's legs. I just farted. You know how. Okay. I have to explain this to you. What do I even Google to show you this? Javier Pena standing from the back. Oh. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, okay, this is good. Because Pedro Pascal's got them slutty little legs and that slutty little waist and hips. And so when a man stands like that, where they kind of like pop their knee out and they rest their hands like right here and their legs are just muscly enough, like all the way down, but they've got that tiny little waist. I want to like get on all fours and like, I'm the alpha. I'm the we are wolves. Oh my God. It's that slutty little stance they do. God damn. I am so touch-starved. So touch-starved. For the love of Christ, somebody, just volunteer. Just do it. And then I'm going to come on this podcast and be like, I think God is the Savior, and I think that eternal life is possible through all that believe. Like, that's going to be me after, like, I just someone fucking touch me for the love of all that is holy, for everyone's well-being. Anyway. Ghost. Back to it, dude. I have moved forward with I have moved forward with the decision to open AO3 and discover all that the world has to offer via AO3. Now, what is AO3? Some of you may be asking. Archive of our own. It is a fanfiction website, not for the faint of heart. It is a fanfiction website for the dirtiest minded, most touch-starved individuals. But you know what's funny is, like, it's not. Because some of the most well-written fanfictions I've ever read in my life have been written by married women who are sitting on the couch typing it with their husband on the couch with them, watching television. They are just so inspired. I don't know what it is, dude. I don't know what it is. But it's like, it's just women. And it's so good. And so I knew that starting on this ghost, just death spiral, because I know what comes next, right? Like I know what fucking comes next, and you know what makes it worse? He's not real. So guess where I fucking landed last night? Ghost cosplayers. Oh, fuck you. Fuck off. I'm at my lowest low. I have never, this is my rock bottom. Ghost cosplayers! I just farted again. Ghost cosplayers! I am a victim. I'm a victim. I'm like really embarrassed. I think I'm done with this episode. I'm feeling like maybe we need to end the episode because it's over. Getting red in the face. I'm hot. My face just got hot. I don't even know, like, if I were to bring this up to my therapist, I don't even know what to say. How do you even approach the subject? So there's this guy, Ghost from Call of Duty Modern Warfare. Oh, he's cute. Terrifying. What is going on? Anyway, I read this fanfiction last night that gave me my life. I was like, I finished it and I had to be like, God. Jesus. I need to go get some ice water. Dunk my head in it. Christ. It was so horny. It was so hot. Ghost? Ghost Ghostbusters! No! 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 Put the Nicolas Cage bit up here again. No! Not the bees! Oh, my life is just like not... If I worked a 9-to-5, I would not be like this, dude. That's a lie. Just lied. Caught myself in a lie. If I worked a 9-to-5, I wouldn't have the time to lay in bed and watch 2 hours of ghost edits on TikTok and then proceed to go into AO3 and read another 3 fan fictions of ghosts for the next hour. That is not right. It's not well. You're not okay. Figure it out. Like, what the fuck? Okay. I'm gonna end this episode because I've fully bared my soul and I can only do that for so long. Okay, first and foremost, we need to get this shit out of the fucking way. Okay? We need to talk about Sleep Token. We need to talk about Sleep Token. And if you're driving right now, again, remember, driving, hands off the wheel, eyes closed. That's how you listen to the Broski Report. Okay, when you're... What the fuck? Sleep Token. I'm going to start taking notes about what I'm talking about. Okay, Sleep Token is a band. Go ahead and throw up a... I'm actually embarrassed. Go ahead and throw up a picture right here of Sleep Token. Sleep Token is a band, and they're British. And they are described as... Sleep Token. Pull up the Wikipedia, coward. Sleep Token are a British rock band from London. Oh my god, my stomach's fluttering. Formed in 2016. The group are an anonymous masked collective. Marry that girl, no matter what you say. That's how I feel about Mass Collective. That song is so fucking stupid. Sleep Token. Sleep Token would never, ever pump out any of this bullshit. Sleep Token is the metal hosier. And I will be the first person to look at you in your eyeballs and say, I don't give a fuck about metal. I love every genre of music, but it is something about metal. I don't respect it and I cannot get behind it. Okay? I listen to metal and I'm like, literally, I'm like, turn this shit off. I don't know what you fucking kids. I don't know what you dumbass kids are. Real music was back in my day. That's how I feel when I listen to metal. Now, having said that, okay? I gave this band a chance because I was like, oh, they're masked. They wear masks. I have a mental problem. I have a mental lack somewhere. I'm lacking in the brain department that makes me this way. And I'm not really motivated to do anything about it. I'm motivated to keep pursuing the things I like that tickle and prod at that lacking part of my brain. Okay, so when y'all sent me a DM and said, hey, Supreme Leader, here's a band full of masked men, jerked it. I freaked it. Oh, there's a band of masked men? Guess what? I'm freaking it. I took her to my penthouse and I just freaked it by myself. A band of masked men? They're British. I took her to my penthouse and I jerked it. That's how I feel. What the fuck are we talking about? I just get really like... I get like... I'm in disbelief some of the bullshit I say. What are we talking about? Sleep Token. Look at them. Okay. There is so much lore here. And they've been a band since 2016. Sleep Token. Progressive metal, alternative metal, post-metal, indie pop. They've been categorized under many different genres, including all the ones I just said.
And it's true. Like, there's a mixture of, sometimes it'll just be him playing the piano. Oh my God, he's so hot.
I don't want to talk about it, actually. That's not, because like, if you don't get it, I'm not going to sit here and try to explain it to you, because I can't explain it. Okay, here, try to get into this.
They like cover themselves completely in black and wear masks so that you don't focus on them. But they're playing these festivals. So you don't focus on them, you focus on the music. Like, that's the whole thing. Is like, the lead singer's name is Vessel, because he's a vessel of the music. And the rest of the band members are literally the Roman numerals 2, 3, and 4. Like, it's a vessel 2, 3, and 4. So I get it artistically. That's why a lot of anonymous singers do that, is because they don't want you to focus on them. They want you to focus on the music. But inherently, I'm going to focus more on your identity because I want to know. Okay? So when I saw this image, and I was like, why does he look like that? Do they roll around in the fucking dirt beforehand? And I was like, no. Because they like cover their whole bodies in darkness, so they're just a vessel. And then these festivals put them out in the midday sun. Like, their festival slot is at like 2 p.m. And so they go out there and they sweat all this makeup off. And then you get this picture. And then I take her to my penthouse and I freak it. Okay, so they play at 2 p.m. I look at this image. They sweat. I lick it up. I go to my penthouse and I freak it. That's kind of the schedule. So they sweat it all off. He's got these big fucking hands. And his smile, he'll smile sometimes. Oh my God. I just love it. I'm obsessed. But it's also here because before you bitches go, don't sexualize them.
Okay, you should listen to their music.
I do. I do listen to their music. I love their music. They're the metal Hozier. Their lyricism and production is something that I haven't heard in years. It is a completely new genre of music, and I'm eating it up with a fork and knife. Also, I took him to my penthouse, and I freaked it. I want to freak him.
My hair is so greasy. Please don't look at me. I need to like not. Okay.
Their whole thing, like I said, I guess is like, they're anonymous. But of course, I literally feel 15. And also my feet are tingling.
Let's get back into it. Sleep token. So they're British and all the band members have. Oh, this is what I was going to say. I feel 15 again.
All the band members have like personalities, because sometimes they'll yell into the crowd, but they're not supposed to talk. But they'll be like, get on your fucking feet. And I say, because you never hear him talk. I'm not joking. I feel like a Victorian man seeing ankle for the first time.
Oh, fair maiden, dost thou lift thine dress to reveal thine ankle?
That's me when I see his neck and his ear. Okay. So that's the lore, is that they don't do interviews. They don't do meet and greets. They don't talk to fans at the show. They don't do bullshit. They're there to perform the music for you. And they call their concerts worship, ? Hey, so that kind of makes me a little,
what do you mean by that? So what do you mean by that?
Are we worshiping him? Are we worshiping the music? Are we worshiping each other?
Just tell me when to take my clothes off. Just tell me when I need to get naked.
Me getting kicked out of a sleep token show because I'm naked.
Well, I thought we were worshiping each other's bodies.
Stupid. Oh my God, I need to make Kylo Ren and Mando kiss.
And they were boys. And they both wanted me.
Holy fuck. I need to go back to sleep token. It's been 100 minutes. It's been 100 million minutes. Okay. Right now I'm really just like trying to get over the fact that it's metal, because sometimes it feels like they ruin a perfectly good song by adding metal at the very end. So I'm just like, come on, guys. Ascensionism, such a good song, then at the end you put freaking metal. But I'm trying to get into it because that was Vessel's artistic choice, and I love it because that's my baby's father. That is my baby's father. The third one in a row, the third week in a row. That's my baby's father. I have so many sleep token edits saved on my TikTok, dude. I like, and he's so good live. Like, okay. They're playing at the House of Blues in Anaheim. Like, relative, like a small band. Like, they're a small band in the grand scheme of things. Still kind of underground. Resale tickets are going for $500. You bitches need to be locked in the ninth circle of hell. I want fucking scalpers. I want you and the people who buy concert tickets and sell them for a price. You're going to fucking hell. Hell is hot. And guess what? The ninth circle, Satan's down there clawing and sucking and licking on bitches. You're going to be there. Buy a $25 concert ticket and sell it for $500. You're burning in hell. Sleep Token is as close to heavy metal as I'm ever going to get. I need to see them so bad. I need him. I have that swelling feeling in my chest and my stomach because I need him so bad. I will never be as attracted to another man as I am to him right now. And I don't even know what he looks like. And that's kind of the premise of this podcast. All right, now we're going to talk about Call of Duty. Oh my god, no, back to Oppenheimer. Matt Damon in a military uniform. Good night almighty. Good night a living. I'll tell you something, boy. Put it up here. Lord, he looked good. Lord, shit. I love Matt Damon. I love Matt Damon in Ocean's 11. I love Matt Damon as Jason Bourne. I love Matt Damon in We Bought a Zoo. I love Matt Damon as, what's his name? Grove. General Grove. Damn. He is a beautiful man. I don't know what it is, dude. Men that look like him. Ooh, I think he's short. I don't care. Who asked you? I'm going to get like thigh reduction surgery. I'm going to shorten my thighs so I can be a tiny little girlfriend. Okay. And then I'm going to get gastric bypass and I'm going to start Ozempic. I'm going to weigh 95 pounds soaking wet. And then I'm going to date Matt Damon. And what are you bitches going to do then? When I weigh 95 pounds soaking wet. You're going to be like, please eat a hamburger. And I'm going to be like, stop. Fine, I'll eat a hamburger. It's going to be, I'm like, I'm full. Because my stomach's the size of a lima bean. Anyway. Okay, Ghost from Call of Duty. Guys, from the last episode where we checked in on this, it is my entire For You page. It is my entire For You page is Ghost and Koenig, but his German accent really takes me out of it, okay? Because Ghost, this is like fucking hell, and it's hot. Koenig is German, so he's like, das ist gut, ja, das ist gut, baby girl. Ja, coming in hot. No. No. So this is gonna be Koenig, okay? Holy shit. What are we talking about? Is it good? Is it good? Is it good? But you know what? If I saw him in person, I'd do this. I see that comment all the time. It's like, I just snorted for no reason. Jesus. When you're so horny, you start oinking, like snorting like a pig. I saw this comment that was like, you know, I'm online thirsting over these Call of Duty military men, but if I saw one of these dudes in real life, I would cross the street to avoid him because he's scary looking. And how pitiful is that? Also, I see so many, so many videos and fan fictions and like, what's it called? Headcanons, where like they're taking a canon character, but then putting him in a non-canon situation. I don't know. Maybe I don't know what headcanon means. of being like, okay, here are little quirks about Ghost and Koenig, or just like video game characters. And it's like, he hates being touched, but when you touch him, it's okay. He kind of flinches away though, but then he's used to it. What are we talking about? I saw one that was like, Ghost has terrible hygiene, so you have to shave his beard for him and teach him how to brush his teeth. What are we talking about? But I'm reading them. Like, there's a moment when I'm doing all this, like I'm doing discovery, right? I'm a lawyer and I'm doing discovery on my clients. Ghost from Call of Duty. Where it's like, am I the weird one? Do I need to step out of my body? Like, hey, let's just pause the TV. And I just need to like look at myself in the mirror for a second and be like, what the fuck are you doing? What are you doing? Let's go outside. Let's go make a nice glass of water. All right, I'm gonna stop you right there, Chief. I'm gonna stop you right there. Look at his body. What, like, am I the only one that appreciates a man in uniform, or am I just like not well? The way his hips like shift around. I got you six. Yeah, affirm. Nice fucking shot. Like, I'm on TikTok like, like, this is a full-blown military assassin. Fucking hell. I like that one. Okay, enough Call of Duty talk. Okay, oh my god, I forgot to talk about fucking Peso Pluma. Thank you to my man. That's my man. Thank you to my man. Hassan Peso Pluma. La doble P. Pura doble P viejo. That is my man. Look at us. That's my baby's father. I'm sorry to like tell you here and now, but that is my baby's father. Dude, for the rest of this podcast, I'm going to be trying to focus on something else, but I'm just thinking about Koenig. We've got to go back to him. Oh my god. Why does he have to talk like that? I have got to show y'all how he talks. Fuck me. Oh my god.
Taking effective fire.
What was that? Like, how are you gonna look like this? How are you gonna look like this? Oh my god. And then, what was that? Him shooting people in the head. What was that? Me think that was a bomb. It just really takes me out of it. Dude, when I'm reading fanfiction about him, because I do. When I'm reading fanfiction about him and it, like, they'll put little parts in German. They'll put parts
of fanfiction in German.
What was that? Stop it!
Better luck next time.
Covering your six.
Where did you like to shoot?
Changing man.
It's no fair to me.
Like, I'm just really, it's too much for me. But ghost lines are sexy and hot. Fucking hell. Oh, that was fucking mint. He's just sexy, dude. And I've recently figured out the voice actor who plays the most recent Ghost, because apparently there's different versions. I don't know bullshit about Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2. But don't I act like it. When I'm reading these fan fictions, I'm like, I'm not, yup. No clue.
Yeah.
Switching mags.
I just like really, now I'm obsessed. Now we have to watch more.
Fuck me, bro. I cannot sit here another minute
without having him. I need him in a way. I need to probably, if, okay. The way that I am thinking about him right now, if it was like the 1890s, they would have hauled me off to an asylum. Like the things I was about to say about him, this is Pixels, okay? This is not a real man. He is an animated video game character. The things I was about to say that I want him to do to me, they would have shipped me off to the loony bin. With what's it called? Mad fever. They would have lobotomized me, bitch. This is getting out of hand. He is not real. I can't do it. I can't do this. Cause y'all ever read fanfiction and you're like, you know what? Love this story, but it's making me suicidal, the fact that he's not real. I used to feel that way about Harry fanfictions too. It's like, this is not weak. You can never have him. No one can ever have him. Oh my God. How did I get back talking about him? I promised I was done with Call of Duty. I was talking about Peso Pluma. God, he's so hot. I got back to my YouTube homepage of Koenig because what was that? Why did he say that? That's about to piss me the fuck off. What was that? Why do men open their mouths? Look, you can't look like that and then do, what was that? Men are cursed. Men were cursed with, they're so beautiful. Like men objectively, and if you're a lesbian, sorry, men objectively are just beautiful. Like they don't even know it. Like the long eyelashes and the beautiful eyes and like full lips and like the male physique, I'm still about to go in on it. And then they ruin it by opening their mouths. You had it so good, brother. And you, what was that? Oh, fuck you. Who's like the main guy in Call of Duty? Who's like the main guy? Is it Soap or whatever his name is? Who's Graves? Also, why are they British and fighting for the American military? Doesn't make fucking sense. It doesn't even make sense. Okay, so that's Ghost and that's the German one. Why are they fighting for America? That's like literally they're not even from here. Me and my friend were reading Ghost Wikipedia page the other night. Trauma. His whole family died. And his dad used to beat on him. And then he like got buried alive and by some cartel in Mexico. And then crawled across the border to Texas. And then like something happened. I don't know. Special ops. Anyway, guys. Tonight I'm going to be working on my novel about Ghost from Call of Duty. So we'll read that next time we do an episode. Okay, hey guys, welcome back. So we left off last week talking about Vampire Jack. And if you're not caught up, hey, now is the time to go catch up. Go back to last week and listen to the end of that episode because I talk about one of my favorite online content creators. Vampire Jack Townsend. Okay, here's a visual for anyone that wants to know. Okay, so I briefly scratched the surface of Vampire Jack Townsend last week. I wish Brooke was here. Brooke would back me up. Shout out Lady Efron. Shout out Brooke Averick. She's really holding it down for the girls. Any podcast I go on, any piece of media that I am on, I'm going to mention Brooke Averick, okay? And that's just a truth that I really hold tight to my chest. Okay, for some fucking reason, let me pop the brakes. My coffee just kicked in. Okay, don't talk to me before I've had my fucking morning coffee and watched at least 17 Vampire Jack Townsend videos. Don't fucking talk to me. Anyway, so this man... This specimen. And yeah, he's hot. All right, you want me to say he's not? He's hot. He's hot. I'm not gonna sit here and fucking lie. Look at him. Is he fucking weird? Yeah, I'm into it. When your boyfriend is a thirst-trapping vampire on the internet. What's going on here? She's hot too. Tell me you're not into that a little bit. No?
Villain, the girl or the world? Antihero, burn it all down. Wait, what? Burn it all.
Not him using the fire. These are the what's going on for so long. The caption. Okay, this is a video. This is a video that he made. He's playing both characters. One is the villain, one is the anti-hero. And the villain says, your girl or the world, pick. And he has his girl in his arms and he says, burn it all down. And then the screen is like shaking and there's fire and flames and he's engulfed in red light. What's the song? I can't deal with that actually. This is the type of, these are the type of books I read. This is literally a book, I would read this book and I would eat it up and I would reread it and I would say, they need to make a new movie. And then I'd go on Tumblr and I'd reblog post about it on Tumblr and I'd make it my wallpaper. I love shit like this. Maybe that's why I like Vampire Jack Townsend. I am a Vampire Jack Townsend sympathizer. Oh my God. Maybe that's why. It's because I love this sort of like fantasy, almost borderline toxic relationships. Almost. Where they love each other so much it's toxic. I'm obsessed with that, dude. Okay, so this video says he's sexiest when he literally wants to unalive you. And it's just really terrifying, blurry android images of Vampire Jack Townsend. And he is hot, okay? I just, like, can't get over. This man probably is, like, a paralegal. This man probably just, like, is a scribe for a court. What's it called when you take notes of a court hearing? That's probably what he does during the day. And then he gets home and he's like, fuck, I have to clock in. Vampire Jack Townsend. So he clocks out of his 9-to-5 and he puts in those fucking red eye contact lenses and he goes, I'm going to suck and wob. And he clocks in, dude, and he delivers us this A+ S tier content every fucking time. And he's gonna do it every time. And you bitches are mad. You bitches are so mad about it because he's eating it up. Yeah, and whatever. Ooh. See, like, how does he do the vampire teeth, do you think? Because they look real. Well, he is a real vampire, apparently. The makeup, I don't. So for audio listeners, the makeup is this red sort of like almost bird-like eyeshadow that comes down his nose. And it's only on his eyes and his nose. And then he's got, like, no other makeup on his face. And then the vampire teeth in. And usually, hey, his chesticles are out, okay? He's showing them boobies. He's showing them yah-yahs. One thing about Vampire Jack, he's got his fucking yah-yahs out. He's got his yah-yahs in his gut. And he's gonna, he wears these rings that go on every single finger. And there's chains that connect them. I'm obsessed with him, maybe, actually. I think you guys need to be obsessed with him the way that I do. I can't deal with it, though. He's hot. Look at him. Oh, my God. Look at him. He is sexy, dude. I'm saving this picture. He is a... Oh, I got to screenshot it. Doink. He uses, like, curl cream, too. He uses Aussie Herbal Essences hair curl product. Oh my God, he has a beard here.
I would like to see the baby.
Oh, it's his cat. And he drew on a beard. Okay, so he's a Star Wars adult too. Vampire Jack Townsend. What are you doing this weekend? These are the type of fuckers I used to match with on like Tinder and Bumble. And then they'd have a violent, passionate hate for women. Hatred for women. Like, literally, they think they're in a fucking movie. They think they're the main character in a movie. And, like, they seem all fun and games, but it's the type of man that's like, don't worry, kitten. I will order us dinner
because you can't read. It's like that sort of shit. Like, these men are so fucking delusional and not in a fun way. Like, trust and believe I'm into this. Like, I'm eating this up with a fork and a knife. But, like, in real life, he's probably fucking insufferable. Where'd that hot picture go of him? Yes, dude. Damn. Damn, he's got some... He's got a rack on him. Going up to a man and saying, nice rack. Okay, let's go through the horny mom comments on this. Someone commented and said, you know, I really have to stop fainting, but I can't help it. What are you talking about? Be the Edward Cullen to my Bella Swan. Girl, I almost, like, I probably commented that. You would make a good toy? What does that mean? What does that mean? She has children and a husband and a butt plug. What the fuck? Where am I on the internet? Freaking love this is amazing. So beautiful and poignant. You're truly one incredible god, king, lord, sire, prince, man, vampire. I don't know what to say. I'm speechless. You're so very special. There was no one in any universe, in any world, in any afterlife as special and beautiful as you inside and out. I'm obsessed with how there's no punctuation in this sentence. Inside as you, inside and out. I've you so very much. You have my heart. I'm under your spell completely. You can't be real. You're too amazing. I mean, every word I say with every fiber of my being, my dear special vampire and friend, dear Jack, dear Vladdy Daddy. What the fuck? Oh my god. Oh my god. And she commented again. With a bunch of hearts and flame emojis. Oh my god. And she commented again. That was a lot. That's literally me commenting under any man that I like's post. You are so special and amazing. With every fiber of my being. That's literally me, dude. She gets it. Holy shit. Ooh, he got a blowout. Yes! Bitch, he got a blowout. He used the Dyson. Oh, it's celebrating his girlfriend. Love you, girlfriend, but that should be me.
What would you do if your favorite vampire came back from the dead? Nah, man, just fucking with you. Still very dead, but it's been a year and I wanted to come by and say hey.
For it. Oh my god.
Oh, that made me so fucking mad.
Oh my god, I'm livid. That was truly something awful. That was like... We need to take a break. We need to take a break. We'll be right back. And we're back. Thank you guys for hanging out during that brief intermission. I had to collect my fucking composure and collect my thoughts and find my peace. I lost my peace for a second. He robbed my peace from me with that fucking video! Okay. So now, to touch back on Vampire Jack. I found another great picture. He looks great here. I don't know what the artistic choice is
behind the contact lenses, because I've never met a vampire that has contacts. Now, let's... Okay, going back to the first part of that sentence, have I ever met a vampire? No. Okay? But if I did, would he probably be wearing contacts? No. Okay, what's the moral of the story here? The lesson that everyone should take home is that we need to bring back pirate blouses for men. We need to bring back frilly and delicate clothing for men. I'm talking crop tops. I'm talking printed tank tops. I'm talking pirate blouses. I'm talking empire waistline, empire neckline. Maybe a nice cowl neck blouse for a man. One of these. We need to bring back this, but for men. A cowl neck top in vanilla? Man, we need to really get into that, guys. I need someone to be on that. I want to see more male yayas this year than any Instagram model, okay? I want to see man boobs. I want to see man boobs on my feed. Give me man nipple, man boob, man underboob, man yaya. That's what I'm asking for Christmas, Mark Zuckerberg. Just send me some more of that. I found Vampire Jack on my Explore page, and I think my Explore page could, honest to God, have me sent off somewhere. If someone ever got a hold of my iPhone and just opened Instagram, I think that I could, there would be grounds there to send me away. Vampire Jack tortures me on a daily basis. I want to love him. I do. He drives me up the wall, dude. I cannot figure out my feelings about Vampire Jack, and I will keep bringing him up until I figure it out. I have been rewatching the golden age of Love Island, okay? I've been rewatching Love Island, and I'm rewatching season 4, which is arguably the best season, because it is. Danny and Jack, come on, bitch. Even though they broke up, and now Danny has a kid, and Jack has a kid, not with each other. I'm devastated, babe. I'm absolutely gutted. Oh, I'm absolutely gutted. And Jack got fucking hot, dude. If any of you guys don't watch Love Island or didn't watch it, this was the season, like, it was when I had just graduated college. It was like 2018, 2019. I think the winner was announced 2019. First of all, look at him. Dude, that's Jack. He was hot on Love Island, but he was like, yeah, dude, look at this. That's crazy. I like him before. I liked him before, okay? Like, he was definitely cute on Love Island, but he does not look like that anymore. Like, he's cute there. Who is that? Who is that? Hold on, let me find this one picture. I said, this one. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Why did he edit it like that? What is the deal with British people like this always being fucking sunburnt? Like they're always just red. It's not even a tan. It's just like red. He's red in all of his photos. It's like a permanent redness. Look at it. Why is he red? Those are some short shorts, brother. Damn. I think it's just like when you're that white, dude, you don't tan. Okay? Your skin just... And then it peels off. It's like bacon. And you already know what I'm going to say. You already know what I'm about to say. Kristoff from Frozen is the ideal man. Who was he voiced by? John Krasinski? Jonathan Groff. Who the fuck is Jonathan Groff? Him? Oh, wait, I knew that. I did know that. Oh my God. He was in Hamilton? Maybe I don't know who Jonathan Groff is. Maybe I lied. Go back to Kristoff. Kristoff, ew, do you want to know? I'm actually not going to reveal that about myself. No, I will actually. And in high school. Oh, Jesus Christ. In high school, I used to read Kristoff and Elsa fanfiction. I just really don't care
anymore. I'll tell y'all whatever.
Did I say Kristoff and Elsa? I meant Kristoff and Anna. It's been so long. Yeah, I used to read fan fiction. Because it wasn't even fan fiction. It was just like continuing. What's that called? Canon? When you read, it's just like a continuation of the normal storyline. But it's that author's kind of interpretation. I was 15. I was just, I have got, look at that. I have got to consume more of this content. And I'm sorry about me blowing out this fucking mic. This poor microphone. I spit on it and lick and suck and gag and choke all over it. I'm licking and sucking and kind of like gagging a little bit on it sometimes. It's just like, sorry, guys. Sorry about that, guys.
And then it started shuffling music after that, and Coulter Wall came on, and there's this song, Cowpoke, by Coulter Wall. And I was like, this sounds like an old guy. I've never heard of him. He must be an old, like from the 60s country music star. Girl, he's like 30 something. He's like current. Coulter Wall. He is 28. No shit, he's 28. Where's he from? He's Canadian. Coulter Wall is a Canadian singer, songwriter, and musician. Known for his deep, gruff baritone and narrative songwriting, Wall's music encompasses country, folk, and Western styles. I know that's right. His self-titled debut album was released in 2017, and his second album, Songs of the Plains, in October 2018. Sleeping on the Blacktop is another one, and The Devil Wears a Suit and Tie are three of his biggest songs. Coulter Wall is doing it like no one else, bitch. I'm going to play a clip of him performing live, so hopefully that YouTube doesn't snipe me, because I just need y'all to hear.
Well, Reverend, Reverend, please come quick. Cause I got something to admit.
What are we talking about, man? Where does that come from? He probably weighs 110 pounds soaking wet. I could throw him in the pool and yank him up by his shoulders and he would weigh half of me. Oh my God. Where does that voice come from? I love Coulter Wall. All of his music is fantastic. He's got that song with Tyler Childers called Fraulein that literally brings me to tears. I love him. I cannot wait to see what he does. Like, what a talent. And he also, like, ranches on the side. Like, he'll go on tour and then he'll fuck off for 6 months and his management can't get in contact with him because he's off on the ranch. He's, like, working with his hands. I need him. Coulter Wall, I don't always look like this, okay? You just wait till I'll be a backwoods Barbie. You just wait, okay? I'm going to go on Ozempic. What y'all said on the last episode or two episodes ago when I was talking about Matt Damon and Oppenheimer. And I just went on this whole like spiel about Barbie, how like you shouldn't have to change yourself and it's the patriarchy and like my body is keeping me alive. How dare you say that it's a commodity, like all this shit. And then 20 seconds later, I was like, I'll get gastric bypass for Matt Damon. I'll get the gastric sleeve if that meant Matt Damon looked at me for 30 seconds. If Matt Damon gave me the up down, like y'all were like, period. So I think that when I go on Ozempic, when I lose about 70 to 80 pounds, I start wearing wigs full time. I'm going to get that. What did Ariana Grande get? Kybella, where she had her like chin fat shaved off. I'm going to get that done. I'm going to have a spray tan. I'm going to get lashes. I'm going to get teeth whitener and then also lip filler. Coulter Wall, then you let me know. Okay. Now I'm not going to come work the field with you. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to be out there picking corn. I got a vegetable garden out here I can't even take care of. Okay. I'm not doing that. And I probably won't cook for you either, but I'll make you giggle and I'll make us money. Coulter Wall, you sing your heart out, baby. I'm going to make us some. I'm going to bring home that fucking bread. I will provide for you and me. This is a family unit. And I swear to God, I will put money and bread on the table. So help me God. I need him so bad. He is so cute. But not even that. I thought he was a 75-year-old man from that fucking voice he's got. Look at his Adam's apple. Christ. I really, really have a deep respect for what he's doing. artistically. And I cannot wait. I am such a fan of his. Now, next, Zach Bryan. Zach Bryan, like, quickly shot up the charts. And I will admit, he's not my favorite. Maybe I just haven't given him enough of a try. Something in the Orange is a fantastic song. Like, cried. And then Niall Horan covered it. Hey, what are we doing? Niall Horan is a country star. Niall Horan is a country Barbie. That's crazy. Can Niall Horan dye his hair blonde again? We're bored. We miss blonde Niall. Give us blonde Niall. I like Tennessee Orange. It's a good song. Is it about Morgan Wallen? I don't know. There's tea in the country music community, bitch. Everybody's sucking and fucking on each other. And when is it my turn? When are y'all going to invite me into that circle? When do I get my liberal country boyfriend? Hit me up. I'm telling you, I don't always look like this. I don't always look like this. I can be cute. Anyway, I've got to go to a ranch. Okay, here's my plan that I'm concocting right now. So give me your feedback on it. To find myself a cowboy. I'm going to She's the Man, Amanda Bynes myself. I'm going to Mulan myself and dress up as a man and go work as a ranch hand. And then I'm gonna buzz my head, and then I'm gonna like wear those button ups and like really tight fitting jeans and boots or whatever. And then one day I'm gonna be working on the field and they're gonna be like, who's this fucking dude? Brody. This is Brody Broski. And I'm gonna show up and be like, hey y'all, how y'all doing? Or whatever. Okay. I just like won't pluck my mustache for a few days. It'll be a full grown beard. I'm gonna lean down as I'm like trying to haul hay or something, and my voluptuous busty breasts are gonna pop out of my pearl snap, and they're gonna go crazy. They're gonna lose it. They're gonna say, it's a woman! And then I'm gonna rip my bald cap off, and I'm gonna shake my hair, and they're gonna be like, and she's hot! It's literally gonna be like a nerdy girl takes off the glasses and she's suddenly beautiful. That's gonna be me when my big tits bust out of my pearl snap on the farm, and then all of them realize they're in love with me. And then I say, are you liberal? And they say, I don't know. And I say, I can change that. And then I sit down with them for 30 minutes and I give them the spiel of their lives, and they listen and they learn. And then I'm like, I can work with this. I need a man who is made out of Play-Doh. A man I can mold and shape and give him a slutty little waist and like a Dorito body with the big broad shoulders, but a slutty little tiny waist. I just need some Play-Doh. I need to be, I think, stuck in a cage and muzzled and be given Play-Doh to play with. Maybe a vibrator. Just like some pottery. I can like make a man, or a poster board. I can just draw on it. I just need to do some arts and crafts alone by myself, probably, is what is sounding like the best remedy here. Anyway, that's my plan. I'm going to snag a man because I'm going to be in drag. I'm going to be in boy drag. And I'm going to go work on a ranch. My big busty areolas are going to pop out of my shirt. And they're going to be so turned on that they have to come home with me. This is literally my plan. Y'all understand my plan. Please, God. And so Clary, fucking Lily James. Oh, shut up. Oh, she just pisses me off. Emily in Paris gets to kiss and suck on Jamie Campbell Bauer, and I don't, dude. She got to kiss and suck and lick on him for a little bit, and I didn't. It's just like, whatever. I don't even care. I'm not even like mad about it at all. I don't even actually care that much. Lily James gets to kiss everyone. Wait. Not Lily James, Lily Collins. Lily James, I'm so sorry, sweetie. Lily James plays Pamela Anderson. I take everything back. Lily Collins is who I'm talking about. Dude, she got to kiss and lick and suck on Jamie Campbell Bauer. That is my husband. That is my baby's father. And did I say that about Peso Pluma on the last episode? Yes, I did. Whatever. I can have more than one baby father. I can have more than one baby. Anyway, he plays the lead in this movie, and he is so, say what you want, okay, oh my god, oh wow, I forgot, he's just striking. I love a bug-eyed man, maybe because I'm a bug-eyed woman. This
book was fantastical and magical. And I remember in this scene, there's one scene where they're in this beautiful greenhouse and Emily in Paris takes him on a date there for his birthday. She's like, it's your birthday, we're gonna celebrate. And he's like, no one's ever done anything like this for my birthday before. Oh my God, oh my God. These are like high quality fucking photos. There's this scene where there's this little circular staircase in this greenhouse for some reason. And it's also, they're like in New York City or something. I don't know. But it's this glass greenhouse on the top of a building. And she like makes him dinner and all this whatever. And it's such a romantic night. And then they're on the stairs right here. And they're about to kiss. And this like Demi Lovato song starts playing. And I remember being 13 being like, that just took me out of it. Like I was so into it. And then I heard Demi Lovato and I was like, that's freaking Demi Lovato. Okay, Demi, what the fuck are you doing here? Took me out of it completely. And then this scene happens where he pushes her up against the door and like kind of tucks her hair behind her ear and like kind of pushes her into the wall. And it's so hot. And he's so much taller than her. And Jesus really died. And it's like so cute. I'm all fucking freaking. I'm gonna fucking freak out. And his hair is the perfect length. Oh, I can't think about that. I have to watch this movie tonight. Even though this is how they had him dressing, dude. This hooded t-shirt cutoff zip-up jacket. Let's be so for real. Jamie Campbell Bauer talks bulking up for Mortal Instruments. He's a twink. That is a twinkie straight man. Is he straight? Is Jamie Campbell Bauer married? Dating Joseph Quinn? Girlfriend. Is Jamie Campbell in a relationship? Jess Maloney. Who is Jess Maloney? Oh, we're about to get to the bottom of this. Y'all are about to see me do a full-on deep dive. Here we go. Here's the Instagram. What does she do? Ooh, this is so fun. What does she do? Okay. Oh, is she a photographer? What does she do? It doesn't say. Her bio doesn't say. Her bio is just simply an ice cube. Okay. Cryptic. Okay. Tagged photos. Oh my God. Okay. So they've been dating for a long they've been dating for a long time. Oh, so they're both tatted from head to toe and they're both sexy. Oh, so I'm humiliated and devastated. This same thing happened with Cameron Kesing a few episodes back. Cameron Kesing from All-Star Weekend. Oh, I'm just pissed off. I really thought that like he was about to be single. We're going to be talking about TikTok whimper audios. And we're going to be listening to some. One moment. Oh, here we go. We got it. We got it. We got it. We have liftoff, team. We have fucking liftoff. I found the video. I found the video, dude. Okay. 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 Here's the thing. I'm going to give a little crash course for the bitches that aren't weird. Okay. If you're listening to this podcast, you're a level of weird. Admit that. But for the bitches that aren't weird like me, let me sort of explain this and put it in context and really almost kind of convince myself how weird it is. So from the beginning, I've always said like women don't want to see dick pics. Okay. We don't want to see it. A dick doesn't turn us on. You know what I want to see? Neck veins. I want to see a neck vein. I want to see hands. I want to see your forearms, dude. You got them veiny ass forearms. You're a slut. You got a slutty little waist and some veiny forearms. You're a whore. I want to see that. Yeah, yeah. Put that on the, yeah. That's what I want to see, dude. I don't want to end up, no more dick pics. Dick pics outlawed in Broski Nation. You can only, if you want to work at a Broski Nation strip club or an NSFW club, you're going to have to submit some photos of your neck. And what's this little piece of meat right here that connects your neck to your shoulders? I want to see some of that. Yup. And then I want to see some, yup, that slutty little waist. I got to see your thighs. That's what, I'm not trying to do all of that. Okay? No one gives a fuck about your dick pic. Put it away. If I see it, I'm taking your phone. If I see it, I'm taking it. Okay?
and you can get it back after class. I don't want to see it again. If you're sending dick pics, I'm taking it and you don't get it back until after class. Okay? You can pick it up in the principal's office. We don't do that here. You don't bring that to school. Anyway, that's what people don't understand, okay? Men don't understand that. We don't want to see those parts. We want to see other parts. The female gaze is what I'm describing, okay? With that being said, that's a little priming. That's a little primer for what we're about to get into on this Christian website, TikTok.com, TikTok.gov. There is a trend on TikTok to... There's a trend on TikTok to ask men how many push-ups they can do. To say, like, I bet you can't do 50 push-ups with the phone on the floor. I bet you can't do that. And of course, because they're men and they're fucking stupid, they're like, yeah, I can. Basically, yeah, I can. And so they'll do it because they're idiots. You fell for it, you dumbass. So they set up their phone so it looks like they're doing a push-up on top of you. And guess what, bitch? We get whimper audios because they're whimpering. And that's what the girls, there's a whole community on TikTok, what I'm trying to get at, that are, they listen to men whimpering. And there are NSFW audios that people make. And it's like, these are the only fans that women are subscribing to. It's sexy audios of like, a cute boyfriend ASMR, or what is it called? Angry British boyfriend ASMR. There are so many YouTube channels and like Reddit threads and all this shit of people, these men who will literally buy a podcast mic and record themselves doing NSFW, like, oh yeah, like audios, and then sell access to it and people buy it. And I've thought about it. I've considered it because I'm a sicko. I'm a sicko. Lock me up, officer. I don't care. If you put it on the internet, I will find it. You put it on God's green earth, I'm gonna find it if it's a boyfriend whimper audio. I'm gonna find it! Okay, before I launch into this, I need you to understand, I'm still in my Call of Duty era. All right, I'm still reading fanfictions. I'm still watching videos. I found a new guy who goes live as Ghost from Call of Duty, and his name's Daniel, okay? And he's on TikTok, and you can look him up. Daniel Ghost Cosplayer, and he's hot, okay? There's another one called Ghost, G-H-O-E-S-T. He makes me actually want to commit violence. Like, I need to commit a heinous crime after I watch one of his videos. Like, I need to be locked in a cage with a fucking muzzle. It's terrible. And I'm out here bearing my soul to you guys in the hopes that I will find community with at least one person. And if I'm not finding community, you guys need to get in on this community, because I'm sick and tired of feeling alone. I'm sick and tired of doing this by myself. I really need y'all to like meet me halfway. Meet me halfway. Where I want to stay with you. Damn, where is Fergie? Fergie would not like these Call of Duty men. I'll tell you that right now. Okay. So before further ado, or without further ado, let's watch this. Like, he knows this! Longer version. longer version. Like cave women. Me want longer version. They're so thirsty. Yeah. Longer whimper audio. I can comment all day long. Oh my God. Oh. Longer. sorry about who I just was. I'm sorry about who I just became for a second. That was not cool. That was actually really not okay, guys. Is everyone okay? Is everyone all right? Are y'all mad at me? Is everyone okay? Do we need to take a water break? That was fucking crazy. And we're going to watch it again. Fuck you. I don't care. It's my podcast. We're watching it again.
Fine.
That's crazy. That is crazy. Y'all got this man to dress up in cosplay from a video game and grunt while doing push-ups so people can simulate like they're boinking him. So they can simulate like they're boinking him, dude. Where do we go wrong as a society? This is so Tumblr coded. Like, that is so Tumblr. Where those GIFs, they used to make GIFs of like One Direction on stage, like humping the air to a song, and they would like flip it horizontal, and like it was like an art form, dude. Any crumbs. God. And now we get this for free? I'm 26. 26 is the new 23, though, okay? Bitch. And 30 is the new 25. So shut up. I'm not afraid of getting old. I pay my taxes on time, bitch. If I want to listen to men on TikTok whimper, I'm going to do it. Because I pay for this Wi-Fi. I pay for my own goddamn Wi-Fi. I'm going to watch what I want. My bills are paid, babe. What else do I got on here? Okay, this is like a bit much. Okay, so if you're an audio listener, I'll describe what's happening afterward. But if you're a video listener, I'm sorry.
Don't.
I can't even finish it. That's about to piss me off. Oh, and I liked it. What the fuck is wrong with me? Okay, it's a Call of Duty cosplayer. It's a Call of Duty cosplayer, and he's handcuffed, and he's rolling his eyes back in his head to the beat, like he's getting dome. Where did I go wrong? Someone needs to cut my Ethernet cord. Someone needs to, like, permanently disable my iPhone and my laptop so I can just not do this. Because I don't even know. I can't explain this. If you put me, like, in a courtroom and I was on the witness stand and you pulled this up as evidence of some, like, fucking mental breakdown I had where I kidnapped some cosplayer and they're citing this as evidence that, like, it was what's that called? Premeditated? And they pulled this up and they said, what's this? I'd say, you got me there, Your Honor. Your Honor. But did you see it? But Your Honor. Your Honor. Look at him. He got the red LED light. They'd say, what is this? This was in your TikTok likes. And I'd say, I'm just a baby. I don't know. I'm just a little baby.
Don't.
That's crazy. What if his mom saw this? What if his mother saw this? Him act like he's getting sucked off on camera. Oh my god! That is batshit crazy, dude. Oh my god. Anyway, whimper audios are a thing. And now an idea just popped into my brain that I need to react to boyfriend ASMR on YouTube. I have got to see what the girls are doing on YouTube. I may even have to buy some to really, of course, for research, to ingrain myself in the community. Okay. To insert myself and ferment myself in the community. Okay. Nothing other than that. No ulterior motives. None at all. I love on the comments of boyfriend ASMR videos, people be like, I am so fucking lonely. Which isn't funny, but it is. The comments are like, I am so fucking touched, star. Oh, wow. Okay. I think that does it for me today, team. Honestly.